Hey, Roadrunners.
We have a great show planned out for this week.
The RM Pride.
The Gregory interview.
And much more on this week's
Roadrunner Report. Hey, did you know that on Saturday, April 29th, our Roadrunners took a series of tests and events in our academic pentathlon and took medals home?
Oh, that's pretty cool. Speaking of academic pentathlon, one of our Roadrunners interviewed Avni Parmar about her experience.
That sounds really cool. Let's go check that out.
Hey, Roadrunners. As an ACAPET member myself, I'm here with Avni Parmar, one of academic pentathlon's finest winners and champions. So what is ACAPET and what did you do there?
So academic pentathlon is an academic competition where we have study guides and we basically study the whole year or most of the year. And then we have a competition against other schools in the county.
Okay, so how long did you practice for this competition?
So we actually got the study guides around October, but I really started studying around December and I've been studying ever since.
So, at the time of the competition, what did you guys do?
So, we had two different types of tests. The first one was like an individual test where we just go in the cafeteria and they give us our individual booklets and we take the test then. And then the second one was, it's like a public quiz. So we actually go out and the audience actually watches us answer questions. And then there's also another one, we take speech and essay, which was done on a different time.
So did you win any medals or prizes?
Yeah, so I actually got 4 medals and 2 plaques. The first one was, I got first place in speech. I got second place in fine arts, third place in math, and fifth place in social science. And the plaques was winning speech, it's this one. And then this one was team high point winner.
Oh, so. Well, good job.
Thank you.
So what was the topic this year?
So the topic this year was World War II, but that doesn't apply to all the subjects. We just did that for the social science, fine arts, and literature. So the fine arts was just art pieces and music from the World War II time period. And the math, we did a little bit of trigonometry and science was about nuclear and atomic physics.
So what subjects did you study most in?
So I actually did a little bit of everything, but I really focused in on fine arts and social science and also math.
Well, this has been it. Thank you for the interview, Avni. this is Allison with the Roadrunner Report signing out.
Hey Devin, I'm smarter than you.
Okay, whatever you say, I mean, you're in seventh grade.
Well, let's find out who's really smarter, seventh or eighth graders.
Let's cut to that clip then.
This is the eighth grade versus seventh grade game show. I'm here with...
Jalissa,
Dominic,
Celeste,
and Ajahn.
Let's get started. So here are the rules. You need to answer all questions correctly if you are capable. When you answer it correctly, you get a point. Team with the most points wins. What first win? Question. How do you write the number 5 in Roman numerals?
Ivy.
No, V.
Yes, you're right.
All right.
That's 1 point for 8th grade.
Pooh Bear.
Okay. Say it as quickly as possible if you know the answer. How many U.S. presidents has there been?
45.
That's correct.
Alright.
Next question.
It's in Madden.
What city is Batman home to?
Gotham.
Gotham.
Fire. That's 3. Come on, 7th graders. What is the answer to this math problem? 13 with an exponent of 2.
Can I use a calculator?
You almost done there? Come on now. Time's up! Okay, next question.
I had half of it.
Oh.
It was 169.
Oh, I was like,
I said
29.
I said 139. I said 139. Oh, well.
Listen carefully. Who was the first president of the United States?
Abraham Lincoln.
That's a point for the 7th grader. She got it. She did.
Oh.
I heard it.
She said Abraham.
I don't even know.
Why Abraham Lincoln?
Shut up.
I don't know. It just popped out.
All right. Next question. When is Mother's Day?
April 15th. No, May 15th.
Yeah. May, not
May
11th.
May 10th.
May 12th.
No.
May 13th.
May
14th.
No.
May
14th?
14th. Wow.
Oh, ooh.
All right. Okay, here's a riddle.
Ooh.
Some months have 30 days. Some have 31. How many have 28?
All of them.
February.
All of them is correct.
Whoa.
I'm tripping.
I've
heard that. Hey, Jean, where are you at?
I said February.
Excuse me, this is my game show. All right. All right, next, last question. It's a riddle. There are 10 fish in a tank. 2 die, 4 drown, and 3 swim away. How many are left?
1. Wait, say it again?
4.
4.
I'll repeat the question. I'll repeat it. There are 10 fish in a tank.
Yeah.
2 die, 4 drown, and 3 swim away. How many are left?
8. No.
7.
8 is the correct
answer.
Oh!
Because they can't
drown.
They can't swim away.
I said
7. 8th graders won. Let's get it. Right?
Yes, you are correct. You guys won by 1 point. Sorry, but you're losers. All right. Thank you for playing.
Wait, give them their prize.
What is that?
It's made out of gold.
Thank you for playing, ma'am.
Golden news.
Thank you for playing, ma'am. This has been 7th and 8th grader game show. We'll see you later.
Ha, I told you 8th graders are better than 7th graders.
Hey, you should have more respect.
Some Roman runners filmed a skit about the R in Pride.
Sounds cool. Let's jump to the clip.
Hey, Roadrunners. This is Slayton, and I'm going to be interviewing Sarah and Allison. Okay. How do you get into Tech Trek?
Well, you first have to be nominated by a teacher to get into Tech Trek by your science and math, right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
Math and science, yeah.
Yeah.
How do you feel when your teacher nominated you?
When our teacher nominated us, I felt really happy because I never really thought I could do something like this. So now that I'm going, I'm like really excited.
At first, when they called me up, I thought I was in trouble. Yeah, like, I did something. Yeah, I was like, what did I do? But then when Ms. Clark explained what I got nominated for and what it was, I was happy, and I was happy to like get this opportunity to be interviewed.
Yeah.
So what is Tech Trip?
It's basically a science and math camp, and there's like 80 girls in total who are going, and like two from Prescott and then like six from Stanislaus County. So
yeah, like they have you can learn coding, you learn math, you'll do science, and I heard on the website that you get to choose your own schedule to pick your classes, so you'll be living like a college student life.
And you like stay in the dorms of the school.
Interesting.
Yeah.
So where is Trek Tech held and when is it?
Tech Trek is held at University of Fresno. So that's cool.
Yeah, on like July?
I think it's
June. I'm pretty sure
it's somewhere in June.
Yeah, somewhere in June.
Thank you guys for being on our show.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah.
Hey Devin, have you ever heard of Tech Trek?
No, what is it?
It's when students get to learn more about STEM.
What's STEM?
STEM is science, technology, engineering, and math.
Let's cut to that clip.
What is up, Yancy?
Are you excited for Ball and Maximus's party?
Heck yeah, I am. We'll get my party on.
Yeah.
I can't help but hear everyone's talking about this party. Bob is like so rude and gross. Did you hear Bob and his brother at the party so everybody can forget about the accident?
Oh, I didn't.
Anyways, for the party, I'm gonna pour hot.
Right, I don't care what you do. Anyways, Yancy, I gave you the gross thing.
I don't want to, and you can't make me stop.
Come on,
you're
being gross.
I think you should respect
and listen to people's opinions.
Don't talk behind people's back.
It's the R in pride. Devin, what high school do you think you're going to next year?
I'm going to Gregory, and I signed up for football.
Well, did you know that the Gregory Athletic Department came and signed people up for sports?
Yeah, Jalea interviewed them. Let's go check that out.
Hi, I'm Jalea, and I'm here with Jim Davis, the athletic director from Gregory. Coach Davis, do you mind telling us what you're doing on our campus today?
Sure. Myself and another coach are representing Gregory Athletics. We're here to let all the kids know who are currently eighth graders at Prescott what we'd be offering over the summer and what sports that we would be offering, obviously, during the regular high school season. We're only here for the kids that have balloted, that are planning on enrolling at Gregory High School. That's why we're here today.
Are there any sports at risk of getting like cut out?
Well, no.
Okay. What sports do they have at Gregory?
All right. In the fall, we have 17 total sports offered. In the fall, we have football, we have cross country, we have water polo, we have girls tennis, we have girls golf, and we have one more sport which I can't think of.
The summer sports, so when do those start?
they start the day after you guys graduate from junior high school. But it depends on the sport. For example, baseball starts on June 1st. Football can start at the end of May. Other sports, the start dates vary by sport. And we're kind of restricted to what we can do based on the CIF.
Thank you for your time.
Well, that's it for this week, Roadrunners.
Nuh-uh.
What do you mean?
Let's give a shout-out to the National History State competitors and Harold Pope track meet participants.
Well, see you guys next time.
Let's get out of here.
Wait, he called me...
That's Davin. Devin.
It was David, watch.
That's Devin.
When they call you Davin?
I'll put it one back. David, I put it back.
Hey. Here. I just drew a blank. Okay, ready for signing up.
Should we give you blinders?
Shh.
Come on, guys.
Go.
Hey.
Okay, ready? Yes. Hold on. Take five.
Look at, you see the resemblance? Look at this, and then...